We're going to start with this one because yes. We want to talk a little bit about day beds. They're really good. They're multifunctional. Yes. You can use them in different rooms in your house, and it's really good if you don't necessarily have a ton of space.
Absolutely.
And you need to multitask in your rooms,
right? It's one of my favorite pieces of furniture. We're also just talking about double duty furniture too, because we do small space issue every year. It's our most popular issue.
Right.
And there's so many great designs happening right now for small spaces that do double duty, like a day bed. So I'm a big fan of those. They're great for people with condos and small apartments and that kind of thing.
Doesn't surprise me. There's so many people living in small spaces.
Totally.
If you're in a big city in this country,
you're living in a small space.
It's so
true.
You need this multifunctional furniture.
And they've
furniture.
Come a long way. Like the sofa bed that we know from yesteryear, where you
yes.
had to, you know, get down and crank it up and those little legs came out and you'd be sleeping on springs.
Yes.
Those are gone.
And people lost limbs,
yes,
right?
Yes, they were not
like,
safe.
Time to get out the sofa bed.
Totally.
Yes.
So this is a great
Heavy.
Example. It's from Kiosk. This is a great example of one that's very contemporary looking. It's so sleek and modern. It's almost like an update on the futon, but
yes.
such a big update. And just look how easy this is. I'm just going to show you.
Okay.
You just give it a push.
That's
it,
goes, it?
That's it.
I didn't lose
Bada
any
boom.
Fingers, nothing.
And
that was easy. I look at this and I think university.
I know, but
right?
it's way better than that, right?
But it's way better than that. So many people, so many of us relied on futons in university. They're very uncomfortable.
Yeah,
this
totally.
Is so beautiful.
This is beautiful. Just need your bedding on top.
Mm-hmm.
And see, to put it up, you just have to give it a little bit of work, and there you
so
go.
So easy.
Totally easy.
Yeah, that's great.
Now this one, I
okay.
love this one, because I love the idea of a sectional.
Me too.
They're so useful, especially for families where everyone wants to pile on and watch TV.
Mm-hmm.
But if you also want to use that room for a guest room, this is your piece, okay?
Okay.
So check this out. It's from IKEA.
We're going to get rid
first
of these?
Get rid of those. I want to show you first this. On this side, there's room for storage, so you can keep all your bedding there, which is awesome.
That's very smart.
So it's clutter-free.
Okay.
And then watch this. All you do.
And you can do it all by yourself?
Yeah. Well, maybe. Give me a
maybe
hint.
Maybe not? Okay.
Give me a hint.
No problem.
Pull it. Oh, my goodness.
There we go.
Oh, my God. It's not going.
This must be a nice shot of our backsides. Stop watching. Don't look.
Normally, it's easier than that. There you go. And it's.
Woo! This is 1, 2, 3.
It's supposed to be easier.
But look at how huge
but it's
this
big,
is.
Right? Again.
This is like a whole family.
It's
also
exactly.
a very bad shot. How am I sitting here? This is your whole family can be on this.
You could
this
either
nice.
Just,
you
and you know
square.
What? Totally still watching TV as a bed. Wouldn't that be fun?
That is very
yeah.
fun. I like it. Okay, now how am
and
I going to get up?
And super sleek. Yeah,
Tell
sorry,
me.
I'm going to help
Thank
you, honey.
Thank
okay.
you very much.
Luckily, I'm not
that
wearing high
heel
shoes.
That was very graceful, wasn't it?
My favorite, I have to say, is the West Elm day bed.
Yes.
Now this is, I think, a hot piece at West Elm. It's been in their line for a while. What's great about it is this lovely window pane effect at the back.
Oh, that is pretty.
Isn't it nice? And this is, it's
Very
made
nice.
To fit a single mattress. So you don't really have to do much, just get rid of the pillows when you have your guests stay over.
Very nice.
And
so
you don't
can
need
use it as a sofa, or you take off all the pillows and use it as a bed.
Yeah, absolutely.
That's very easy.
So what I want to show you now is my favorite, okay?
Okay.
It's a DIY. So I love the idea of making your own day bed. So I have an example here for you guys to take a look at what you can do using a box spring for the bottom part. So you just buy a box spring mattress,
yeah.
you upholster it in the fabric of your choice, and then you add these beautiful legs. These are a great example from this company called Pretty Peg.
Very
and you get
cool.
a very customized look, right?
Okay, so pass me that leg for a second.
Aren't they pretty?
These are kind of funky, and it's going to give you, you know, that little bit of statement detail,
Absolutely.
Which is really nice
mm-hmm.
to have on your furniture. And a lot of people do have box springs.
Yes.
You know, like sometimes you have that extra box spring. Isn't it a good idea to just wrap it around with some material?
So easy
and
to
then
do.
You've got your own little bed going
yeah.
on.
Yeah, and we've done it, actually, on this ottoman. I think we have a picture of what it looked like before.
Okay, so you did it with an ottoman, so this is to show you how easy it is what you could do with a box spring or an ottoman. So there's the ottoman beforehand.
Yeah, so it had these very simple bun feet, very nice,
yeah.
you know, classic, but if you want to jazz it up, this is what you can do. And you see we added these feet right here.
Oh, very cute.
And it looks totally chic, very different.
Sexy little legs
yeah,
there.
Yeah, I love the gold caps. That's my favorite part, that
yeah.
little bit of that brass detailing.
Absolutely,
very
a little bit of bling.
A
I
little bit
that.
Of bling. Every room needs that.
Okay, so let's talk to our other guest experts about day beds, because you know, you hear about these transitional pieces, these multifunctional pieces. Where would you, Brian, use a day bed in one of your clients' homes?
We're using sofa beds a lot because a lot of clients are moving to condominiums.
Yeah.
And they don't want a guest bedroom that has a bed in it that's only used 2 or 3 weeks a year.
Exactly.
Right. So they want to make them into TV rooms or home offices, and it's better to have a sofa bed in there that you can use the room as a TV room all the time, and then when you have a guest, open it up because they're much more comfortable to
I have
to
a day
be.
Bed in my home office in case I need to nap.
It works really well.
My favorite
it works
thing.
Really
well.
That's very smart, and it's a very good point. We don't have guests all the time.
We don't. That's
so
the
why,
thing.
That why room a... is such a waste it if is. You're not right. using it all the time.
So why have a room have a bed in it that's yeah. used?
That's used never, right?
So little. Right. Why not use that room all the time, and then when the guests are over,
it's
the grandchildren whole... or the kids, you open it up.
It's
absolutely.
The whole double duty
Love
thing.
That. Okay, yeah. great stuff, Suzanne. Thanks
Thank
for that.
You.
Let's go to break. It's home day. Stay with us.